Hello, everyone. Okay, I'm going to stop pretending that I have a Western accent, and we're just going to go into Corona Mountain. Because today we're recording the freaking finale of Super Mario Sunshine. Now, in the last time that I actually recorded anything, I did a whole bunch of blue coins, and that was without commentary. You may notice that my sound quality might be a little different. That's because I have a new microphone, since I got a laptop recently, and the old microphone that I had would not work on the laptop, no matter what I tried. I mean, seriously, I tried everything, and I could not get it to work. So I had to go buy a USB microphone, which set me back some money. Ow. Basically, this level is Corona Mountain, as if you couldn't tell already. I already got the blue coins here in the previous video, just because I felt like it, and I just wanted to put it in the montage. But, as you know, this level has the boat in it, which is considered one of the hardest mechanics in the game. I don't find this portion of the boat too difficult, but when you, like, are trying to get all the blue coins on the boat, that's what I find difficult about the boat. I mean, like, doing this right here isn't too difficult. The only difficult part I would say about the boat level right here is that you have to navigate right in between this brick thing and the spires, and that can be kind of annoying. But otherwise than that, it's kind of a free ride to the end. And then when you get to the end, this is that circular area where 9 of the 10 blue coins were in Corona Mountain. But right now, because we already did that, we're just going to grab the rocket nozzle and save and continue. That's the last time you're going to be seeing that screen. What you're going to want to do is you're just going to rocket jump and try and get up on these clouds here. It's gonna be awesome. There's a 1-up in the center, but since I already have 31 lives, I'm not gonna risk going for that. Okay. And if you fall down, it's not the end of the world. Because if you land on that red box, you pretty much don't take any damage, which is a really helpful shortcut, but you need to be accurate. Now here's a cutscene.
Sure is, Papa.
It looks like barf or something. I mean, really, Peach would love to go swimming in barf, especially Bowser's barf.
You again? Don't you ever give up?
No, I never give up. I'm like Dora the Explorer. I don't give up, even when Swiper. Okay, why am I bringing this up? This is random. So anyway, about the microphone that I got, it's a Logitech USB headset. Cost about 30 bucks. I had the one I wanted picked out. It only costed about $20, but then it turned out that it was analog, like what you would consider a normal headphone jack input, not a USB, and so that was a downfall. For some reason, my laptop can't do a normal input of Alright, for some reason, I'm having a really hard time with this boss fight. I mean, this is one of the easier boss fights. Basically, you gotta dodge Bowser's flame like I'm not doing. I think I'm... There we go. So anyway, if you haven't noticed what I've been doing, I've just been ground pounding. If I actually manage to die, I'll be angry. Okay. Ah, come on! All right, well, that's stupid. Anyway, this final boss usually takes me about 2 tries, even though it's really not that hard. It's just a matter of knowing what you're doing. And the falling platforms are kind of glitchy, like you can fall off easily. The thing is, I always think I can outrun his fire breath, even sometimes when I can't. The bullet bills are kind of annoying. I mean, they're not the biggest threat in this fight, but... Oh yeah, you can get 1-ups if you spray the blue bullet bills, which will refill your water if you run out of it, basically. That's about it. That's all I can think of, really. Yeah, I think I got a technique down. You have to move as soon as you spray. Okay. Anyway, so... My laptop is awesome. I mean, it really does good stuff. I mean, it's got an awesome processor. It set me back quite a bit of money, but I mean, it wasn't really that much. It was just slightly annoying. Okay, we did it. Apparently, that's the last shine sprite in Super Mario Sunshine, so we are officially done with this project. Can't believe it. I'll be quiet here for the cutscene. Floating boobies, what? Okay, that didn't make any sense. For some reason, the X from the blue coin is still there in the background. Even though I clearly cleaned that up. Flood is dead. Oh my god. I'm so sorry. It's a game over in the left screen. Yes. Yes, you were. I will mourn your death forever. Okay. Never mind. Something about a shine sprite? Okay, there we go. That's pretty good. For some reason, that shine sprite seems a lot bigger than all the others. Also, this is something I should mention. This is the only, like, 3D Mario game where you don't actually collect the final shine. You don't actually run up and grab it. It just gets added to your tally when it joins the shine gate, which is kind of strange.
Difficult to tell you about Princess Peach.
I know, she's not really my mama.
True dat.
Someday, when I'm bigger...
And harder. Okay, I just had to.
I wanna fight that Mario again.
And rip his girlfriend. His fake husband, actually. From Mario Party. Probably shouldn't bring that up. Let's just rest a while. Yeah, make out scene, what? Okay. I'm really having bad commentary. I'm like jumping on every perverted thing I could possibly say at once, and it's probably annoying for you, but... Oh well, what are you gonna do about it? Something about a vacation. Okay, now we're gonna have the credits here, and I just have to put in my 50 cents about this game. And I know, the graphics are pretty good for this game, honestly. Difficulty, not that difficult. Well, at least for me, but the blue coins were some of the most annoying things ever. I mean, really, it was like stupid how I had to run around and get all those blue coins in the montage. And, I mean, it was glad when I was done, but overall, this game is a really good game. It's very underrated. It's like, to paraphrase Chugga Conroy, it's like a black sheep of a great series, but honestly, I don't really view it as that. It's a really good game. Anyway, we get to listen to awesome jazz music and have fun memories of watching Chugga Conroy's Let's Play of this game, who was actually good at Let's Playing this game, unlike me, because this is my first project, actually, and you probably already knew that, but yeah, so I don't really get this part of the credits. The music is like, are there like fans cheering? But there's no stadium in this game. That would be for like Super Mario Strikers or something. But oh well. See, it's like, yeah. So apparently, I like this game a lot. I do like this game a lot. So pretty much, this is your ending picture. If you didn't get all 120 shines, you'll have a picture of Il Piantissimo standing on Gelato Beach, and he's, like, looking at, Bowser Jr.'s magic brush, and there's, like, something, it's kind of weird. You have collected all the shine sprites. Do you want to save? Hell yeah! 120. Nintendo I don't want to watch the cutscene again. Okay, whatever. Alright, so this pretty much concludes Mario Sunshine. I mean, it's really, that's not much to it. I mean, this is my second time completely playing through the game, and it was really awesome doing a Let's Play of this. And if, I know I don't have many subscribers at this point, but I thank anyone who did subscribe for the support and the views and the likes and comments. Especially Thane from school, you're awesome. So, if you go to the score, you got pretty much everything done. That's it. But there is one last thing I'd like to show. And you've probably already seen this because I've already shown the sunglasses portion of this. So I will join at pretty much every other Let's Player who's done a Let's Player of this game by ending the project talking to the sunglasses and shirt man. Hey, sunshades alone just won't cut it for you. Nope. You also need one of my custom tropical shirts. Here you go. My oh my, I haven't seen anyone look good, that good in my gear in ages. Come see me when you want to fuck them again, okay? Okay, so apparently, after you, beat Bowser, I mean, you don't have to have all the shine sprites, you unlock the ability to, get the tropical shirt. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Remember, Mario is a prisoner. He was sent to jail. So what I think we're gonna do, so we're gonna put Mario back in jail! Woohoo! Have fun rotting in a prison cell. See you again next time when we do another Let's Play. And we'll leave off with a shot of the Shine Gate has also opened. Blah blah blah.